I'm Gaia.
Hello everyone, I'm Tara.
And we're both part of the TG Tribe. We explore the world of vitality and try to unlock the secrets of living longer and feeling stronger. So we'd love to learn what keeps us humans healthy and happy for as long as we live, which might be forever.
Who knows?
So if you enjoy this video, please don't forget to like it and make sure to subscribe to help grow the channel.
Please like and hit the button with the word subscribe on it.
In a world overflown with diets,
from keto to paleo, vegan to carnivore,
one question rises above the rest.
What if the key to unlocking time wasn't in a potion, but
right on our plates?
Today, we're on a quest, a journey through flavors and time
to uncover the ultimate diet for longevity.
Longevity isn't just about living longer. It's about living healthier and happier for a longer period of time. And diet plays a crucial role in that.
Ever noticed how diets pop up faster than
popcorn?
From shedding those extra pounds to getting that summer glow, there's a diet for literally everything. But wait. While some diets are all about the right now results, we're going on a culinary quest to see which ones are playing the long game. So buckle up. In this video, we'll dive deep into the world of trendy diets and see which ones get the golden star for longevity. Let's munch our way to the truth.
Enjoy the fruit of your longevity.
First up on our culinary adventure, the sizzling, fat-fueled world of the keto diet.
You keto, by the way? You look like you keto.
No.
It's high in fats, moderate in proteins, and very low in carbs. It's designed to put your body into a state of ketosis where it burns fat for energy.
To understand what this diet is all about, let's compare our bodies to a car.
Wait, what?
I know it might sound strange, but just bear with us for now.
So imagine for a moment that your body is a car. Most of us are running on regular unleaded fuel, also known as carbohydrates. Bread, pasta, sugar, you know, the stuff that makes life sweet.
More minestrone, more pasta, another loaf of bread.
But what if I told you there's premium fuel out there? One that might just give your engine a little extra vroom vroom. That, my friend, is fat.
Enter the keto diet, where we flip the script. Instead of filling up on those tempting carby treats, we're going all in on fats. Think of it as trading in your economy car for a luxury sports car that runs on high-octane avocado, butter, and bacon.
Bacon, my love, bacon!
But wait, you cry, aren't fats the bad guys? A common misconception.
The bad guys aren't bad guys.
In the whimsical world of keto, fats are our BFFs and carbs, well, they're that friend who always crashes on your couch and eats all your snacks. We still love them, but in moderation, like see you on special occasions kind of moderation.
Now, I hear you asking, what happens when we go full throttle on fats?
Magic.
Your body, being the adaptable machine it is, goes out of carbs, no problemo, and starts making these nifty little things called ketones. It's like your body's backup generator, ensuring you keep cruising smoothly on the highway of life. But a word of caution, the transition can be, let's call it interesting. Ever heard of the keto flu?
What did you say?
It's like your body's way of saying, whoa, new fuel? Give me a sec. It's a bit grumpy at first, but give it time and it'll be purring like a kid. In conclusion, the keto diet is like giving your body a VIP pass to the fat fuel party of the century. Just remember, before you put on those dancing shoes, have a chat with your doc to make sure you're ready to boogie.
While many swear by its weight loss benefits, its long-term effects on longevity are still under research. The main problem is the amount of fat consumed.
Why is that a problem?
Picture fats as those clingy stickers that never quite peel off cleanly. Our bodies, being mostly water, look at fats and think, you again? After all, our watery bodies and fats mix about as well as oil and water, which is to say, not at all.
Not even slightly.
Fats, being the attention seekers they are, love to stick around, sometimes in places we'd rather they didn't. And some of these fats, especially the long-chain saturated ones, are like party crashers, causing inflammation and riling up our immune cells. Others decide to throw after parties in our liver, and trust me, it's not the fun kind.
We've got a party crasher.
But wait, plot twist. Not all fats are mischief makers. Some, like butyric acid and caprylic acid, are the unsung heroes doing wonders for our health.
What a plot twist!
So while some keto enthusiasts might tell you to have a fat fiesta, and others act like fats are out to get you, the truth is a bit more nuanced. It's like a detective story where not everything is as it seems.
Mysterious.
Now, the keto diet's claim to fame? The glitzy state of ketosis. But here's the scoop. While ketosis is like the VIP section of the metabolic club, how you get past the velvet rope matters. Binging on animal fats and proteins is like trying to sneak in through the back door. But with the right balance, you're dancing the right way. In short, when it comes to fat, it's all about finding the right rhythm and knowing which dance partners to choose. So the keto diet won't be getting 5 stars as a longevity diet. However, there might just be one such diet that has the potential to claim the prize for the best longevity diet. Wondering what it is? Tell me, baby. Tell me, baby.
The Mediterranean diet. It is considered one of the healthiest diets, as studies have shown that people following this diet have lower rates of heart disease, certain cancers, and even Alzheimer's.
Maybe I'm getting that bad memory disease.
Alzheimer's?
Alzheimer's, that's a bad memory disease. Why would you mention that?
It's all about those healthy fats and antioxidants. Let's delve a little deeper into this mysteriously good Mediterranean diet.
Ladies and gentlemen, first order of business, pack your bags because we're going on a vacation. The destination?
Somewhere in the Mediterranean.
Not just the sandy beaches of the Mediterranean, but also its bustling markets, aromatic kitchens, and sun-drenched vineyards. Welcome aboard the Mediterranean Diet Cruise.
How can I go on a cruise without my cabana wear?
The Mediterranean diet is rich in fruits, vegetables, whole grains, and olive oil. It emphasizes fish over red meat and includes moderate wine consumption. Now, it isn't just a diet. It's a lifestyle, a vibe, a mood.
It's a lifestyle.
It's like if the food pyramid went on a summer holiday and came back all tanned, relaxed, and sipping on olive oil.
Olio di oliva.
Imagine if your food plate was a party. Veggies are grooving, fish are making a splash, and olive oil? Oh, it's DJing this whole shindig. That's the Mediterranean diet for you. A fiesta of flavors where every bite is a celebration.
Celebrate good times, come on.
First up, let's talk ticker. The Mediterranean diet is like a love song for your heart.
When you dance down the street with a cloud at your feet, you're in love.
Studies have shown that folks who embrace this diet have hearts that beat stronger and longer. It's like they've got the stamina of marathon dancers.
Now, not all fats are created equal. The Mediterranean diet is all about those good fats. Think olive oil and nuts. They're like the VIPs in the club of longevity and the science. It's their biggest fan, linking these fats to reduced bad cholesterol.
My cholesterol is a little high.
Veggies here aren't just sidekicks, they're the main act. Rich in antioxidants and fiber, they're the superheroes fighting off those pesky aging villains. And the research backs it up, linking a high veggie intake to a reduced risk of chronic diseases.
Wow, look at this. Do you know what this means?
The Mediterranean Sea isn't just for sailing. It's a treasure trove of fish rich in omega-3s. These fatty acids are like the smooth jazz of the diet, keeping inflammation at bay and making sure your heart stays in rhythm.
Rhythm you feel in your heart.
A glass of wine, a glass, is often on the menu. But remember, it's all about moderation. It's like adding a sprinkle of glitter to your outfit. A little goes a long way, and studies suggest that moderate wine consumption can be heart-friendly.
Who wants some vino?
This diet isn't just about what's on the plate. It's about the laughter, the stories, and the memories shared around the table. And believe it or not, social connection and happiness play a role in longevity too.
Don't worry, be happy.
In conclusion, if you're dreaming of a life where every meal feels like a Mediterranean sunset, where your heart dances to the beat of good health, and where the promise of longevity is served with a side of olives, then this diet might just be your jam. So, raise your glasses, folks, to a life well lived and a diet well loved.
Ladies and gents, ever wondered what your great, 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 add a few more greats, grandparents ate? No, not the ones who love jello salads. I'm talking way back, like caveman days. Welcome to the paleo diet. It's all about channeling your inner Fred Flintstone.
Fred Flintstone speaking.
Imagine a world without microwaves, without pizza delivery, and without Wi-Fi.
You can't do this. You can't take away the Wi-Fi.
That's the paleo vibe. If a caveman couldn't eat it, neither can you. So processed foods like grains and dairy are out. But on the bright side, you get to feast on meats, nuts, and veggies. Think of it as a culinary time machine, minus the dinosaurs.
Now let's hop over to France and meet Mr. Dukin, who's not just about berets and baguettes. The Dukin diet is like a four-act play where protein is the star. Act 1, pure protein. It's a meaty extravaganza. Chicken, fish, tofu. If it's protein, it's on the menu. Act 2's, veggies join the party. Greens make their grand entrance, but carbs are still waiting in the wings. Act 3, bread and cheese cameo. A slice of bread and a bit of cheese make a guest appearance. Ooh la la. Act 4, the happy ending. One day a week, you go back to Act 1, the meaty extravaganza, just for old time's sake. It's a diet with drama, flair, and a touch of French elegance.
Sounds French. I love the French. Did you know that they invented mayonnaise?
Last, but not least, let's groove back to the 70s with Dr. Atkins. This diet is all about cutting those carbs and making fats and proteins your new BFFs. Picture carbs as those disco songs that get stuck in your head. Fun in moderation, but too much and it's overload.
Information overload!
The Atkins diet is like a dance floor where fats and proteins are doing the hustle and carbs are chilling on the sidelines. It starts with a low-carb intro, then slowly reintroduces them as you groove on. But remember, it's not about boogieing down with just any carbs. It's about choosing the right dance partners. So whether you're vibing with Cavemen, enjoying a French culinary drama, or grooving with Dr. Atkins, remember, diets are like dance styles. It's all about finding the right rhythm for you.
Now do your shimmy. Shake your shimmy, girl. Come on, yeah, show me your stuff.
It's worth noting that while these diets may offer short-term weight loss benefits, from a longevity perspective, they may not be the best diet after all.
Dang it.
Imagine, for example, you've just bought a shiny new car. At first, it's all smooth rides and admiring glances. That's like the short-term effects of some diets. Zooming in the fast lane, feeling invincible.
I'm invincible!
I came to say invincible.
But fast forward a few years. You've been fueling that car with the wrong kind of gas. It starts to sputter and cough. From a biogerontological, yeah, it's a mouthful, think aging science, perspective, some diets might just be that wrong kind of gas for our bodies, potentially speeding up our biological clock.
I'm getting old.
Picture this. Our cells are little factories. Over time, they can get cluttered with proteins, kind of like my garage after a decade of hoarding. This protein buildup isn't just a cellular version of spring cleaning gone wrong. It's linked to some heavy hitters like Alzheimer's and heart issues. And guess what? Gorging on animal proteins is like sending those factories extra shipments they didn't order.
I don't need it.
Now let's talk about the cell's VIP club, the nutrient sensing pathways. When you munch on meat, you're basically giving amino acids a backstage pass to this club, especially the superstar mTOR receptor. And while it sounds cool, this party can speed up aging. It's like throwing a wild party every night. Fun in the short term, but exhausting in the long run. So next time you're about to dive into that steak, remember, everything in moderation. It's not just about the ride, it's about keeping that engine purring for the long haul.
You must tend the engine. Keep her humming.
All right, we've danced with Cavemen, waltzed through France, and boogied with Dr. Atkins. But now, let's slow things down and sway to a more heart-healthy rhythm.
Sway now.
Gaia, introduce us to the harmonious world of the Ornish diet. The Ornish diet is a low-fat, high-fiber vegetarian diet.
It was at this moment that she knew. She fucked up.
Vegetarian.
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 It's been shown to reverse heart disease and improve various other health markers, and from a longevity perspective, it's actually a very good diet to follow. Let's dive deeper into the nitty-gritty of this diet.
The devil's in the details.
Have you ever dreamt of finding the fountain of youth? Well, spoiler alert, Ponce de Leon might have been looking in the wrong place.
Discoverer of the fountain of youth.
Instead of trekking through Florida, he should have just popped over to Dr. Dean Ornish's kitchen.
To the kitchen!
To the kitchen!
To the kitchen.
Imagine a world where burgers and fries are replaced with beans and rice. Where your plate looks like a rainbow and meat is that distant cousin you see once in a blue moon. That's the Ornish universe for you. The Ornish diet emphasizes whole grains, fruits, veggies, while limiting fats, meats, and sugars.
You're not supposed to eat sugar, it's bad for you.
Let's kick things off with the good old pump, the heart. The Ornish diet is like a personal trainer for your heart. Studies have shown that this diet doesn't just slow down heart disease, it puts it in reverse. It's like your heart's very own time machine, dialing back the years.
Are you telling me you built a time machine?
This diet is all about keeping your fats on the down low.
It's like your meals went on a Marie Kondo spree and fats didn't spark joy. And the science? It's singing along. Low-fat diets have been linked to lower bad cholesterol levels. So bye-bye fats, hello heart health. Baby, bye-bye-bye. The Ornish diet is where veggies are the rock stars. Think of it as Coachella, but with broccoli headlining. And the crowd, that's us, gets a dose of antioxidants, fiber, and all the good stuff that's linked to a longer, healthier life. But it's not just about food. The Ornish way brings in exercise, turning you into a lean, mean, age-fighting machine. Regular exercise is like a magic potion for longevity. And guess what? It's Ornish approved. Meditation and stress reduction are also on the menu. It's like giving your mind a spa day every day. And studies, they're nodding in approval, linking stress reduction to a longer, happier life. I'm gonna live forever. Dr. Ornish didn't just whip this up on a whim. Clinical trials have shown that participants on the Ornish diet experienced artery unclogging. It's like giving your insides a spring clean. In a nutshell, if you're looking to not just add years to your life, but life to your years, the Ornish diet might just be your golden ticket. So here's to twirling through life with veggies in hand, a song in our heart, and laughter lines that come from years of genuine joy.
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 From the harmonious tunes of the Ornish diet, let's switch the record and dive into the wild, wacky, and wonderfully unconventional world of diets. Tara, what's next on our culinary playlist?
Well, Gaia,
brace yourselves because we're about to embark on a fruity adventure with the raw fruit diet. And then, just when you think things can't get any quirkier, we'll pop on some stylish blue glasses for the vision diet. Ready to feast your eyes and taste buds?
Feast your eyes upon this, mateys.
Isn't the raw fruit diet the one where bananas are the steak, strawberries are the fries, and a handful of blueberries is, well, the blueberry on top?
Exactly.
Okay. The fruitarian diet is like the VIP club of vegan diets. It's so exclusive that even some veggies can't get past the bouncer.
You shall not pass!
This diet is all about celebrating raw fruits in all their juicy glory. So picture this. It's a world where apples are your appetizers, berries are your main course, and watermelon, that's your dessert. The raw fruit diet is like attending Mother Nature's exclusive party, and only fruits are on the guest list. It's all about embracing your inner Tarzan or Jane and munching on fruits like they're going out of style.
Jane, Tarzan, Jane.
But remember, while fruits are fabulous, they're also sugar-packed. So it's like dancing on sweet, sticky dance floor. But wait, it's not just a fruit fiesta 24/7. You can occasionally invite some veggies to the party, sprinkle in some dried fruits, and maybe even throw in a handful of nuts and seeds for that crunchy encore. So if you ever dreamt of living in a world where watermelons are the main dish, pineapples are the dessert, then the fruitarian diet lifestyle might just be your jam. Or should I say fruit salad? But here's the twist. While it sounds like you're sipping on rainbows, it's essential to balance the act. You can't just throw in fruits and call it a day. While fruits are packed with vitamins and antioxidants, relying solely on them can lead to nutrient imbalances. It's essential to have a varied diet to ensure all nutrient needs are met. You need some protein, maybe a dash of healthy fats, and definitely some greens. Think of it as a smoothie symphony, where every ingredient plays its part. Our bodies thrive on a mix of nutrients, so it's essential to find a balanced diet that suits your individual needs. And always remember to consult with a healthcare professional before making significant changes to your diet. All right, Tara, we've had our fruity fiesta, but now it's time to switch gears and add a little color to our culinary journey. Ready to see the world of diets through a different lens?
I am ready to quest.
All right, folks. Gather round, because I'm about to introduce you to a diet that's less about what's on your plate and more about, well, how you see it. Ever thought of adding a dash of fashion to your meals? No, I'm not talking about edible hats or spaghetti scarves. I present to you the Vision Diet.
What are you talking about?
Wait. Tara, are you telling me I can eat my triple chocolate cake, my cheesy pizza, and even my grandma's famous buttery mashed potatoes? Absolutely, Gaia. But here's the catch. You've got to view all those delicious treats through some snazzy blue tinted glasses. That's right. The Vision Diet allows you to munch on anything and everything your heart desires, but you've got to be rocking those blue shades while doing it.
Shades? You want shades? I'll show you. Shades. Look at that. Huh?
So it's like turning every meal into a blue-themed disco party. But why blue? Great question. The idea behind this colorful diet is that the color blue acts as an appetite suppressant. Think about it. How many naturally blue foods can you name? Blueberries might be waving their tiny hands, but that's about it. The color blue is believed to make your food look a tad less appealing, so you might just find yourself eating less without even realizing it.
Now that's cool.
It's like Mother Nature's way of saying slow down on the snacks. But the real question is, does this diet have the longevity stamp of approval? Well, while the idea of suppressing appetite might just sound promising for weight management, there is no solid scientific evidence linking the Vision Diet directly to longevity. Plus, longevity isn't just about eating less, it's about eating right. So while those blue-eyed glasses might make your fries look less tempting, they won't magically turn them into a salad.
Dang it!
So if you're looking for a fun conversation starter at dinner parties, or just want to jazz up your meals, the Vision Diet might be worth a try. But for longevity, it's always best to focus on a balanced diet rich in whole foods. And hey, if you want to wear those blue glasses for fun of it, go right ahead. Just remember, they won't turn that cheesecake into a plate of veggies, sadly.
How disappointing.
After our colorful journey with the Vision Diet, let's now set our sights on a different shade of blue. A blue that's not about glasses or fashion, but about the regions of longevity and vibrant living. Delving deeper into our quest for longevity, we turn to the Blue Zones Diet, a testament to regions where life isn't just lived, but celebrated well into the golden years. Have you ever wondered where the Fountain of Youth might actually be hiding? It's not in a secret cave or at the end of a rainbow. It's scattered across pockets of the world where people are living their best, longest lives. Welcome to the magical realms of the Blue Zones. Imagine a place where turning 100 isn't just another birthday, where grandmas can outdance you, and where folks have more life in their years than years in their life.
And longevity, how old would you say I am?
That's a blue zone for you. And guess what's at the heart of it? Their diet. It's primarily plant-based, with a focus on legumes and low in processed foods.
I don't eat junk food.
In blue zones, veggies aren't just a side dish, they're the main event. Think of them as the rock stars of the plate, belting out tunes of fiber, antioxidants, and all things good. Studies have shown that a plant-forward diet is like a VIP pass to the longevity club.
Welcome to the club.
The more you eat, the longer you live. Beans are a staple in these regions. They're like the unsung heroes, quietly working behind the scenes, packing in protein and nutrients. And science gives them a standing ovation for their role in heart health.
A standing ovation?
Whole grains are the confetti in the Blue Zone party. They're complex, they're fun, and they're oh so good for your gut. Research links them to everything from better digestion to reduced risk of chronic diseases.
All of that?
In the Blue Zone show, meat isn't the lead actor. It's more like a guest star, making an occasional appearance. This limited intake is associated with a reduced risk of several health issues, making room for more plant-powered goodness.
I mean the bare necessities or Mother Nature's recipes.
Just like a good party has a toast, Blue Zones have their wine. In moderation, of course. Studies suggest that the glass here and there, especially red, can be heart-friendly. Cheers to that.
Cheerio.
It's not just about the food. Blue Zoners are movers and shakers, literally. They weave physical activity into their daily lives, be it gardening, walking, or dancing. And guess what? Regular movement is scientifically linked to a longer, happier life.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it.
One of the secret ingredients in the Blue Zone recipe? Strong social ties and a sense of community. It's like having a support squad cheering you on every step of the way. And research? It's cheering too, linking social connections to mental well-being and longevity. In a nutshell, if you're dreaming of a life where age is just a number, where your plate is a colorful canvas of health, and where every day feels like a celebration, the Blue Zone diet might just be your ticket to the party. So put on your dancing shoes, grab a bowl of beans, and let's boogie our way to longevity.
What beans? There's beans?
From the vibrant longevity parties of the Blue Zones, let's shift gears and explore a different rhythm of eating. One that's less about what you eat and more about when you eat. Gaia?
What do you want?
Introduce us to the intriguing world of intermittent fasting. Have you ever thought about giving your stomach a little vacation? Maybe a short break, a siesta, if you will. Welcome to the world of intermittent fasting, where your belly gets some well-deserved time off. Think of it as a dietary version of Netflix and chill. Sometimes your digestive system just wants to kick back, relax, and binge-watch its favorite shows without the constant influx of snacks. That's intermittent fasting for you. Scheduled eating with intervals of, well, not eating. The idea is simple. You have your feasting hours and you have your fasting hours. It's like the sun and moon of your dietary universe. When it's time to eat, you eat. When it's time to fast, you channel your inner zen and let your body do its magic.
I'd love to eat right now, but I can't.
During fasting, your body isn't just twiddling its thumbs. It goes into repair model. Autophagy, a fancy term that sounds like a dance move, is your body's way of cleaning out damaged cells. Studies have shown that this process is a booster for cellular health and longevity. Intermittent fasting helps stabilize blood sugar levels. It's like your body's way of saying, I prefer steady rides over roller coasters. And science gives it a thumbs up, linking stable blood sugar to a reduced risk of type 2 diabetes.
Diabetes!
Your brain on fasting? It's like it's had a double shot of espresso. Fasting boosts the production of brain-derived neurotrophic factor, BDNF, which is like brain fertilizer. More BDNF, better memory, mood, and cognitive function.
Wow, really?
Let's face it, one of the reasons many folks try intermittent fasting is to shed some pounds. And guess what? It can help. By reducing eating windows, you often consume fewer calories. Plus, fasting periods can boost metabolism. It's like turning your body into a calorie-burning furnace. Intermittent fasting has been linked to improved heart health markers like reduced inflammation and lower cholesterol. It's like giving your heart the green light to groove to the beats of good health. Let's groove tonight. If you're looking to give your body a break, boost your brain, and maybe even fit into those jeans from college, intermittent fasting might just be the lifestyle hack you've been waiting for. So grab your timers, set your eating windows, and let's embark on this fasting fiesta. Fiesta, fiesta, bailando como esta. All right, folks, let's wrap this up with some golden nuggets of wisdom. Remember, there's no one-size-fits-all magic diet wand. It's more like a wardrobe. You've got to find the perfect fit for your unique body and fabulous lifestyle. So here's the ultimate cheat sheet for living your best, longest life. Ditch those plain starches and invite nutrient-rich foods to the party. Choose Quinoa's company over that tempting bread and pasta. They're the cool kids on the block. Plant-based milk is the new black. So chic, so healthy. Limit those red carpet appearances of red meat. Instead, roll out the welcome mat for fatty fish, poultry, tofu, and those fancy mushroom alternatives. Hydrate like you're in the Sahara with mineral water. Sip on some green tea, and if you're feeling wild, go for a coffee marathon, but cap it at 5 cups. Aim for a colorful plate with diverse natural ingredients. From the greenest veggies to the spiciest spices, they're not just a treat for your taste buds, but also a boost for your health and mood. Get your groove on with fermented foods like kimchi. Your gut will thank you with a happy dance. While a glass of wine might sound divine, recent studies are giving it the side eye. Moderation is key. Consider adding some backup dancers to your health routine like selenium and vitamin D3. In a nutshell, it's all about balance, variety, and listening to your body. So there you have it. The secret to longevity might just be on your plate. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more insights. Until next time, and as Spock said so elegantly, live long and prosper.
Live long and prosper.
What did I say? We had it slower and it went.